Oh man, the moment we've all been waiting for. WeCreat has finally launched their brand new 1064 nanometer infrared laser module. With this new laser module, you can engrave so many more materials than you could before. Think of things like gold, silver, metal, stainless steel, jewelry, and so much more. In this video, we're gonna unbox the new laser module. I'll show you how to install it, and then I'll show you some projects that I made using it right away. This machine previously was only a 20-watt diode laser, which is great for making wood projects, but not so great for engraving metal projects. But with this new infrared laser module, you can tackle all of the projects that you couldn't before. So now this machine is basically a 2-in-1 infrared and diode laser engraving machine. I don't know if there's any other laser engravers on the market that are fully enclosed and a 2-in-1 diode and infrared laser. This might be the only one. Let me know in the comments. Am I missing one? I know that the laser pecker has a 2-in-1 infrared laser, but that thing is very small and tiny. This one is nice because it's fully enclosed, so you don't have to worry about smoke getting in the room, and it's a big machine, so you can do really big projects in it. So being able to switch up the different kinds of materials that you can engrave with this new laser module is so cool. Let's unbox it and I'll show you how easy it is to swap this out. So this is what the new laser module looks like. It's like some kind of metal coasters that we can test on. Came with 5 metal coasters. And this is the control board.
Looks like we've got some zip ties, some little screws, and an Allen wrench. And that's it. Here's a close-up of everything that came in the box. The metal coasters, the zip ties, screws, Allen wrench, the control board, and the laser module.
Now that we've unboxed everything, I'm going to show you how to install the new infrared laser module on the WeCreat Vision. We need to swap out the diode laser with the infrared laser.
So the first thing that you want to do is make sure that your machine is off. Then you can pull this up and drag it all the way over to the right. This little black part right here flips up, just like that. And then you can pull out this little white strip, just like that.
Next, you want to grab your Allen wrench because on the back of the laser module, there's 4 screws. 1, 2, and then there's 2 more down here. So take your Allen wrench and then we're going to unscrew these 4 screws. Make sure you don't lose these screws because you're going to need them to attach the new laser module. Now we're going to gently lower this onto the bed. So right down here, there's a zip tie. We need to snip that zip tie. Be careful not to damage this tube because this is your air assist tube. And then we're going to unscrew this. Now we can remove the laser head. This is how the old laser head looks compared to the new one. So the old one is a little bit smaller. In case you're wondering, the heads look like this. So let's see how to install this. So you want to take this metal piece and slide it all the way over. And then on the back of here, you'll see 4 little screw holes. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's where we screw those 4 screws that we just unscrewed from the other laser head back in. So we need to slide this into the slot. If this is hitting, you just got to move it over a little bit, just like that. Should fit nice and snug. And then grab your screw, and we're just going to get it started a little bit to hold it in place, and I'll tighten them all after. This last one's a little tricky because you can't see it, so you just gotta feel. And then we can tighten them all up.
Perfect.
Now we're gonna grab this little white cable and slide it in here as far as you can. There's a little slot closer to the top of it. And then once you get it in as far as it goes, push down this little black piece. And give it a little tug, make sure it's secure. Then we're gonna work over on this side. So this little plug right here, we're just gonna pull out. Just like that. Then we're gonna pop up this little black piece and pull out this ribbon cable. And then we're gonna grab our Allen wrench and unscrew these two pieces. Now we can pull out this little piece and make sure you don't lose this because this is what you need when you want to swap your diode laser back in. So every time you want to go back and forth between the diode and the infrared laser, this is what you need to do. There's this little metal piece right here. You kind of got to slide it underneath there so that the holes line up. Now we can slide this back in here. If you're trying to get this in the hole and you can't, make sure you flip up this little black flap. Then you can slide it in. Once you get it in as far as you can, flip that little black flap back down. Give it a little tug, make sure it's secure. Then we're going to grab this and plug it back into here. Perfect. You don't need the air assist with the infrared laser, so we're just going to leave this as is. Now we're going to connect it to the computer and start making some cool stuff.
This is where it says the laser is connected. If it says 2-watt, that means that the 2-watt laser is connected. You can go to the settings and turn the air assist to off because we're not going to be using it with this module. Watch us transform this ordinary candle lid into a touching keepsake. If you have a Cricut machine, you can even make your own candle labels out of printable sticker paper. Check out this tutorial on my channel to learn how. Did you know that you can even laser engrave laptops with the WeCreate? Watch me add this cute mama design to the front. If you're wondering where I found all of these beautiful designs, they're from Creative Fabrica. They're my go-to place for all my fonts and designs. They have thousands of laser engraving files, color images for sublimating, and SVGs for all of your project ideas. If you don't already have a subscription to them, click the link in my video description for a free 1-month trial. Their all-access subscription is only $5 a month and gives you unlimited commercial access to everything on their site. A commercial license is what you need if you want to sell your laser engraving projects. I took one of the metal coaster samples that came with the module and laser engraved this pretty butterfly on it. I'm really impressed with how good it came out. Laser engraving metal is a breeze now with this new infrared laser module. My most favorite thing to laser engrave so far with this new IR laser module has been knives. I had my daughter write, "We love you, Dad," on a piece of paper. Then we took a picture of the paper, removed the background, and laser engraved her handwriting on the knife. It came out so cute. I'm definitely adding this project to my Etsy shop soon. I really love being able to laser engrave so many new materials with my infrared laser module. You're probably wondering, how much does the new infrared laser module cost? It's currently listed at $349, marked down from their original price of $599. This is a great deal, so get it before it's gone. If you're interested in purchasing one, then click the link in my video description to bring you right to the page where you can learn more. Since I am a part of their affiliate program, I will earn a small commission at no additional cost to you, if you make a purchase through my link. If you guys enjoyed this video and learned something new, I'd appreciate it if you hit that like button, subscribe and turn on your notifications so you never miss out on a new video. What do you guys think of this new IR laser module? Let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one.